Mr. Granger.
Junior?
It's Davis the second these days.
It suits you.
You know, I don't remember your name being on the guest list, Brandon.
Your wife invited me. After the bumping.
So what have you been doing with yourself these days?
I'm a photographer.
It's an interesting hobby.
It's a profession. I run an online publication.
Called?
I doubt it's anything you've ever heard of.
You're one of those, huh?
So how about you? Did Daddy finally take you on at the firm?
I don't work for my father. In fact, I've been elected to public office up here the last 4 years.
Don't tell me. Mayor McCoy.
Nothing so insignificant, Brandon. In fact, I'm the district attorney these days. You enjoy yourself, Mr. Granger, and don't forget, we prosecute DWIs to the fullest extent of the law.
Hey, man.
A little help over here.
Hey, nice arm. You want to go and throw a little in the back?
Yeah, okay. Good.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Hey, I'm sorry. You did this.
It's okay, Brandon.
Phelps, he's dead.
Yeah, but not the way you think he is.
There ain't no parents, there ain't no school. We'd swim all day and fish all night long.
And we never grow old, Brandon, never. It's like that place in Peter Pan.
Neverland.
Yeah, Neverland. That's why I came to find you.
Hey, did you get yourself lost?
This is crazy.
It's real. I can take you there. Remember that cave down by Limbo Creek?
Yeah, I remember.
Okay, be there in 3 hours. And don't forget your fishing pole.
Hello? Phelps?
That pole big enough for you?
Oh, damn it. It was on sale.
Well, where we're going, you just might need it.
And where is that?
The swamp.
The cypress swamp? Man, we found it that one time. We never saw it again. I figured we just imagined it.
Yeah, well, that's how things happen. You see things when you're a kid, and when you get older, you can't seem to find them anymore.
Look, maybe Neverland's just for kids.
You think you're grown?
I'm 33.
Turning old is just like being born. You can't help being pushed out, but taking that first breath is all up to you. You ain't done that yet, Brandon. You ain't turned.
Yeah, well, I'm not so sure.
I don't care what you're sure about. I'm gonna take you there right now. All you gotta do is cross this bridge. You've come this far. You've gotta want it.
Oh. Oh my God, it's real.
The hell are we supposed to catch out here anyway? Alligators?
Brandon knows.
The Lunker. Old mudhead catfish.
Hooked him once, right in here, when we were about 10. He got away, though.
Well, how big was he?
Big.
Holy shit!
Yeah.
Hey, look, Brandon, I got another one.
Nice. Oh.
Oh shit!
You
oh,
got him.
God. Oh shit!
Come on!
Shit! Come on!
Whoa!
He's gone. Oh. God damn it!
You believe me now?
When can we go again?
That's what I need to tell you about. Me and Derek, we can go anytime we want. We can go to places even better than this. But you, if you want to go again, you gotta bring another boy to the pond.
What'll happen to him?
He'll get saved, just like us.
Aw, Jesus.
Don't get all funny on me now. You've seen it for yourself. It's real.
Yeah, but he'll die.
Call it what you want. But tell me what part of life is worth living after 13.
Who do I bring?
Go to the funeral.
My funeral.
You'll know him when you see him. We'll be waiting for you at the pond.
Sorry, kid. I didn't mean to scare you.
You're that drunk guy from the party, aren't you?
Yeah.
What are you even doing out here?
I guess I could ask you the same question.
I ain't doing nothing wrong. He was my friend.
Listen, kid, I understand. I had a friend of mine died 2 years back. His service was a damn joke, and this one just brought back some bad memories.
I didn't even know him.
Yeah, it was the same back then. What, you want some?
Liquor?
Yeah. You ever had any before?
Me and some friends had some tequila once.
Did you like it?
I reckon we did.
Yeah. That's the way it is when you're a kid. You drink when you're young because you're having fun. You drink when you're old because you have to.
Why is that?
Pray you never know. Attaboy, drink up. Enjoy yourself while you can.
It's sweet.
It's brandy. Go on, have another slug. I can save you, you know.
Save me?
I'm walking home. Andy. Andy, wake up. We're here.
Where?
We're here. It's gonna be okay, kid. I swear it. Is he the one?
Yeah, it's him.
You did right, Brandon.
Okay, wait. What if he doesn't want to go?
It's crazy.
Yeah? Well, what if?
We can't take him if he does not want to go. Look, he'll wake up right there tomorrow, and he won't remember anything.
Jesus H. Christ. Riley, it's me. Hey, I'm in the Como Motel, room 111. She give me its call when you get a chance. Right.
Aw, your little kingdom by the sea.
Riley?
Call me Lo.
All right, Lolita, I guess that makes me Humbert Humbert.
You can be Humbert Humbert, and I'll let you paw at my prepubescent breasts.
Or?
Or you could be Quilty, and I'll let you put it in my ass.
I want to be Quilty.
All right, let's go, Q. I want to be bad. Fuck me, Quilty! Fuck me, Quilty! You sweat scotch, Q. Right in all my little holes.
You keep talking like that, you're gonna get yourself into more trouble.
Let me shower first. Then you can get me dirty all over again.
Yes?
Mr. Granger.
What do you want?
Your current location to begin with.
Yeah, okay, well, you can forget about that. Is there anything else?
As a matter of fact, there is. Things are absolutely falling apart here. Smitty's come up with crap the last 4 mornings, and all Johnson got was yet another traffic accident.
So then run it.
Mr. Granger, I don't think you're aware of the situation. I just got off the phone with the rep from Fetish. They're quite upset that we've come up with 4 mornings of crap the day after we signed them.
Yeah, well, fuck them.
Fuck them? They're going to fuck us, mate.
Tell you what, I'll send you some of the photos I took before I left town.
Well, what do you have?
You're getting them?
Not bad.
Right. Okay, now listen. I want a black and white and stark, like a police photo, if you can think you can pull that off.
Not a problem. But we're going to need more than one dead woman. We're talking nearly $500,000 here.
Yeah, well, I'll think of something.
I certainly hope so. And one more thing, Mr. Granger. About Christmas.
Jesus, you just will not let that go. I'm telling you, you're working Christmas. You're all working Christmas. And one more question, you ask me one more time, I swear to God, you better dust off your fucking resume.
News from Hamlin Pond. Details are sketchy at best, but it appears another young man has taken his own life. This comes less than 4 days after another youth suicide took place no less than a dozen yards from this spot where I'm standing right now.
It's you. Corpses with coffee. That is so fucking cool.
Yeah, I guess it is.
Maybe you should get a shot of the boy.
What boy?
It's been all over the news since this morning. There's been another suicide, Brandon, at the pond.
I see, yeah. Well, yeah, I guess I could approach one of the deputies who needed a couple extra dollars.
No, I wouldn't try anything like that. These good old boys just might try to shoot you for asking.
Then what do you suggest?
The morgue, Brandon. We'll go tonight.
Okay, wait. What if there's somebody inside? Seems pretty quiet.
Too quiet. We need to be more careful than you know, Brandon. Morgues are now being used by government operatives.
You're kidding.
I wish I was. There's evidence that the CIA has developed a device that allows the government to record your dreams. Record them and steal them, Brandon. They take the recorded dream and they place it in the mind of a corpse for a single night. And then when they're ready, they take that dream and place it back in your head while you're asleep. The dream remains unaltered, but it possesses an air of morbidity.
Riley, what the hell are you on?
Rohit Mall and a single malt scotch. Yourself?
Janitor.
Behind this curtain. God. I've never come like that before in my life. It was like drowning.
Look, we gotta hurry. Safe about that. I don't usually take photographs directly of their face. And if I have to, I can use a soft focus, I can blur it.
He's really dead.
He is. Why don't you stand guard? Are you here?
That was quite an experience. He was so cold.
They all are.
I can't be alone tonight.
Come over to the hotel.
Davis is out of town. Follow me home.
All
right. Hey, make us a drink. I'll be right out. I'm scared too, Brandy. Just put the medication in his orange juice. That's what my parents did to my birth control pills. I know. I'll call you tomorrow, okay? Good Lord. Brandy Daniels.
Her son won't take his medication. She believes him to be suicidal.
Well, is he?
Mm-hmm. Possibly. He was the one at the funeral with, all that black eyeliner. Damien. If you ask me, two suicides in 1 week has this town all acting up. If only they knew we were at the morgue.
Yeah, well, what if they knew I was here?
Oh, they'd expect that. But the morgue? It really was a thrill, wasn't it? A little more disturbing, but less creepy than I'd imagined. Just the opposite of that old Poe story about the morgue. Do you remember how that one ended?
There was a monkey, right?
An orangutan.
Oh, same thing.
What a disappointment.
Yeah, the Rohypnols are definitely wearing off.
Good. I'm picking up the old College Station tonight. You know, I was always a sucker for the sad stuff.
Yeah, why is that?
I don't know. There's just something touching about young, melancholy men pouring their hearts over lost love.
Lost love.
Of course. It's the most agonizing thing of all.
You're wrong. It's lost youth. That's what this music is. It's nostalgia for college kids.
Brandon, what do you see?
Snow. I see falling snow.